Now let us complete the table. The first row headed by 0. 0 into 0 is 0. 0 into 1 is 0. We know 0 into any number is 0. Therefore, this is 0, 0, 0, 0. Now we are going to fill the row headed by number 1 or the second row. 1 into 0 is 0. 1 into 1 is 1. 1 into 2 is 2. 1 into 3 is 3. 1 into 4 is 4. 1 into 5 is 5. Now third row headed by number 2. 2 into 0 is 0. 2 into 1 is 2. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 3. 2 into 3 is 6. Whenever 6 is divided by this number 6, the remainder is 0. Therefore, we have to write 0 here. 2 into 4, 8. When 8 is divided by 6, 2 is the remainder. 5 twos are 10. When 10 is divided by 6, the remainder is 4. Now, the row headed by number 3. 3 into 0 is 3. 3 into 1 is 3. 3 twos are 6. When 6 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. 3 threes are 9. When 9 is divided by 6, the remainder is 3. 3 into 4, 12. When 12 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. 3 into 5, 15. When 15 is divided by 6, the remainder is 3. Now let us fill the row headed by number 4. That is 4 into 0 is 0, 4 into 1 is 4, 4 twos are 8. When 8 is divided by 6, the remainder is 2. 4 into 3, 12. When 12 is divided by 6, the remainder is 0. 4 fours are 16. When 16 is divided by 6, the remainder is 4. 4 fives are 20. When 20 is divided by 6, the remainder is 2. Now let us fill the last row headed by number 5. 5 zeros are 0, 5 into 1 is 5, 5 twos are 10. When 10 is divided by 6, the remainder is 4. 5 threes are 15. When 15 is divided by 6, the remainder is 3. 5 fours are 20. When 20 is divided by 6, the remainder is 2. 5 fives are 25. When 25 is divided by 6, the remainder is 1. Thus, we have completed the table. And remember that A, Madhukin Mallo, B is the remainder or non-negative remainder when A into B is divided by M. A, Madhukin Mallo, M, B is equals to A into B if the product is less than M. The product of A and B is less than M, we write as it is. For example, 2 into 2, 4, which is less than 6. So we wrote 4 as it is. Therefore, whenever the product is less than M, we write the product. If the product is more than M, then we have to use the first one. That is A multiplying modulo M, B equal to the non-negative remainder when A into B is divided by M. Suppose A into B is a multiple of M. If it's a multiple of M, then we have to write 0. For example, if it is 6, 1, 2, 3s are 6. We have to write 0. 4, 3s are 12. 12 is a multiple of 6. Therefore, 0. So whenever it's a multiple of M, we write 0. The product is less than M, we write the product. If it is more than M, we write the non-negative remainder. In the ring R, we observe that neither 2 nor 3 is equal to 0. See here, neither 2 nor 3 is 0. But what is 2 multiplication modulo 6 into 3? 2 multiplication modulo 6 into 3. That is nothing but 0. This is 0. So 2 Manishi Mall 6, 3 equal to 0. See here, this is 2 into Manishi Mall 6 into 3. This number is 0. And remember that 2 is not equal to 0. This is not equals to 0. Even this 3 is also not equals to 0. But the product 2 into 3 is 0. This is very interesting and important one. That is, 2 is not equal to 0 and 3 is not equal to 0 implies 2 into 3 equal to 0. This never happened in any other branches of mathematics. This is a really wonder. 2 is not equal to 0, 3 is not equal to 0, but 2 into 3 equal to 0. In so far you have learned, if two numbers not equal to 0, their product also must be not equal to 0. But here, the product of two non-zero elements is equals to 0. This is one of the wonders in mathematics. Already we have come across many wonders in modern algebra. The one is in Boolean algebra, we already proved that A plus A is not 2A, it is 0. In Boolean ring, A plus A equal to 0. But in general, A plus A is 2A. And another thing is, in Boolean ring, if A plus B equal to 0, then A equal to B. But in general, it will be, if A plus B equal to 0, then A equal to minus B. Whereas in Boolean ring, if A plus B equal to 0, then A equals to minus B. Therefore, we have many wonders in modern algebra. This is not the only 2 and 3. We have few more elements. That is, 4 into 3 is also 0. See here, 4 is not equal to 0 and 3 is not equal to 0, but this element is 0. This element is 0. Here also 0. 3 into 4. Thus, we have 4 not equal to 0, 3 not equal to 0, whereas 4 into 3 is equal to 0. So in general, we can say A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0 implies A into B equals to 0. This is happens in the case of multiplication modulo 6. This implies the elements A and B are called zero divisors. The elements small A and small B are called zero divisors. So in this example, 2 and 3 are zero divisors. 4 and 3 are zero divisors. In a ring R, if A is not equal to 0, B is not equal to 0, but A into B equal to 0, then we say that two elements A and B are zero divisors. Then what is the zero divisors? The zero divisors are nothing but, if A is not equal to 0, B not equal to 0, A equals to A into B equal to 0. For example, in the previous table, 2 is not equal to 0, 3 is not equal to 0, whereas 2 into 3 equals to 0. This can be written as, 2 into 3 equal to 0 can be written as 0 by 3 equal to 2. But remember that in mathematics, 0 by any number is 0, except 0. 0 by 5 is 0, 0 by 8 is 0, 0 by 3 is 0 in mathematics. But whereas in modern algebra, in the case of addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6, where capital R is equal to having the element 0 to 5, we have 0 by 3 equals to 2. That's why it is called zero divisors. That is, 3 divides 0, it gives a remainder is 2. which never happen in other part of mathematics. Similarly, we can also write 0 by 2 is equals to 3. Therefore, here this number 2 and this 3 are zero divisors. So the definition of zero divisors is A not equal to 0, B not equal to 0 implies A into B equal to 0. That is the two non-zero numbers which gives their product equal to 0. Therefore, numbers are called zero divisors. And in the above example, 2 and 3 are called zero divisors, as well as 3 and 4 also known as zero divisors. What is without zero divisors? This is the one normally we have in mathematics. A is not equal to 0, B is not equal to 0 implies A into B not equal to 0. You take any number, A is 5, not equal to 0. 3, not equal to 0. 5 into 3 is 15, not equal to 0. Or equivalently, we say that A equal to 0 and B equal to 0 implies AB equal to 0. Or you can say AB equal to 0 implies either A equal to 0 or B equal to 0. That is called without zero divisors. Now we have examples of zero divisors and without zero divisors. First, we'll discuss about example of zero divisors. Just now we have found an example. We have discussed an example that R, addition modulo 6, multiplication modulo 6 is a ring with zero divisors. Another example is M addition into multiplication. Let us see what is this example. M is equals to set of all matrices A, B, C, D, where A, B, C, D are rational number, integers, are real numbers, are complex numbers. The A, B, C, D may be integers, are rationals, are reals, are complex numbers. Choose two elements from this set. Let us take M1 is equal to 1, 0, 0, 0. M2 equals to 0, 0, 1, 0. M1 is not equal to 0 because M1 is not a zero matrix. M2 is not equal to 0 because M2 is not a zero matrix. What is their product? M1 and M2 equals to 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0. We are going to multiply this row by column matrix. 1 into 0, 0, plus 0 into 1, 0. So 0 is the first entry. Similarly, first row, second column. 1 into 0 plus 0 into 0 is 0. Now, second row, first column. 0 into 0 is 0 plus 0 into 1 is 0. So 0 plus 0 is 0 here. Similarly, second row, second column. 0 into 0 is 0 plus 0 into 0 is 0. And hence, this element is also 0. Hence, M1 is not equal to 0 matrix. M2 is not equal to 0 matrix. But M1 into M2 equals to 0 matrix. Therefore, this is another example of zero divisors. That is, M1 not equal to 0, M2 not equal to 0, whereas the product M1 and M2 equals to 0. So, this is another example. Therefore, now we have two examples of ring with zero divisors. The first example is, just now we discussed the ring R having elements 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. With respect to addition modulo 6 and multiplication modulo 6, the other example is M, comma, plus, comma, dot, where M is the matrix of order 2 by 2 or N by N. You can take any type of matrix. The reason is the matrix multiplication is not commutative in general. Therefore, whenever you want to have an example of ring with zero divisors, we can take this example. Now, what are the examples of ring without zero divisors? Ring without zero divisors, we have many examples. This is a natural one. Zero divisors, without zero divisors is a natural one. When you say without zero divisors, A not equal to zero, B not equal to zero implies A, B not equal to zero. If A zero, B zero, then A, B must be zero. Or A, B equal to zero implies either A zero or B zero. These are all without zero divisors. The examples are set of integers with respect to ordinary addition and ordinary multiplication of integers. Then set of rational numbers with respect to addition and subtraction is a ring without zero divisors. The next one is set of real numbers with addition and subtraction. The next one is set of complex numbers with respect to addition and subtraction. So these are all examples in which we take any two non-zero elements, their product also not equals to zero. Therefore, ring without zero divisors, we have many examples. But ring with two zero divisors, we have very few examples. Among the few, we have discussed two examples here. Next is the definition of integral domain. What is an integral domain? A commutative ring with unity without zero divisors is called an integral domain. A commutative ring with unity without zero divisors is called an integral domain. So when you say integral domain, it is a ring with the commutative property. It must have a unity element and it must have without zero divisors. Examples, just now we have discussed examples of without zero divisors. All those examples will be the examples for integral domain. Z comma plus comma dot. Z is set of integers, set of rational numbers, set of real numbers, set of complex numbers. These are all examples of integral domain. And remember that the capital R having element 0 to 6 with respect to addition modulo 6 and the multiplication modulo 6 is not an integral domain because that ring has zero divisors. But integral domain must have without zero divisors. Now we have another example. Prove that R comma addition modulus 10, multiplication modulo 10, where R is equals to 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. These are all even numbers. Is a commutative ring with unity. Is it an integral domain? Yes. Let us start. The first one, we have to show that R comma addition modulo 10 is abelian. For that, we have to prepare the composition table. I hope you all know how to prepare the composition table. Even if you don't know, please learn because very important. Now we write the elements of R. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Here also elements of R. 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Now here the operation is addition modulo 10. And we know how to fill the columns. That is, since here it is the addition modulo 10, if the sum is less than 10, write the sum. If the sum is 10 or multiples of 10, write 0. If the sum is more than 10, we have to divide the sum by 10 and write the remainder. Therefore, the first row, 0. 0 plus any integer is the same integer. Therefore, it's very easy to fill the first row. 0 plus 0 is 0, 0 plus 2 is 2, 0 plus 4 is 4, 0 plus 6 is 6, 0 plus 8 is 8. Now, 2 plus 0 is 2, 2 plus 2 is 4, 2 plus 6, 2 plus 4 is 6, 2 plus 6 is 8, 2 plus 8 is 10. When 10 is divided by 10, what's the remainder? 0. Now 4 plus 0 is 4, 4 plus 2 is 8, 6, 4 plus 4 is 8, 4 plus 6 is 10. When 10 is divided by 10, the remainder is 0. 4 plus 8 is 12. 12 is more than 10. Therefore, divide 12 by 10, the remainder is 2. Now the fourth row headed by number 6. 6 plus 0 is 6. 6 plus 2 is 8. 6 plus 4 is 10. Since the sum is 10, here 10, therefore 0. 6 plus 6 is 12. The sum is 12 more than 10. Therefore, divide 12 by 10. The remainder is 2. 6 plus 8 is 14. The sum is 14, which is more than 10. Therefore, divide 14 by 10. The remainder is 4. Now, the last row headed by the number 8. 8 plus 0 is 8. 8 plus 2 is 10. 10 is divided by 10. The remainder is 0. 8 plus 4 is 12. When 12 is divided by 10, 2 is the remainder. 8 plus 6 is 14. When 14 is divided by 10, 4 is the remainder. 8 plus 8 is 16. When 16 is divided by 10, 6 is the remainder. This is how we have to fill the column. The first one is closure property. What's the closure property? If you look at the elements in the table, the elements in the table are, this is the one. These elements are in the table. And all these elements, look at this, all these elements are from the set capital R. Therefore, it is closed. We say that R is closed with respect to addition modulo 10. Associative, we know how to close associative law. Let us take three elements A, B, C from R. That is, the ABC may be any of these elements 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. For example, A may be 2, B may be 8, C may be 4. So we have to take a general element. Then A addition modulo 10, B addition modulo 10, C is equals to. We know that A addition modulo 10, B equal to A plus B mod M mod 10. Therefore, this A addition modulo 10, B, the suffix 10 can be eliminated. We can write simply A plus B plus addition modulo 10 C. Now we are going to apply the result. That is addition modulo M. Addition modulo M is nothing but the least non-negative remainder when the sum is divided by M. Therefore, A plus B addition modulo 10 C is nothing but the least non-negative remainder when A plus B plus C is divided by 10. What are ABC? ABC are elements of R. What are the elements of R? They are all integers. We know that the integers obey associative property with respect to addition. Therefore, A plus B plus C can be written as A plus B plus C. Therefore, you can write the least non-negative remainder when A plus B plus C is divided by 10. That is equals to A addition modulo 10, B plus C. Since B plus C is nothing but B addition modulo 10 C, and hence A addition modulo 10 B plus addition modulo 10 C is equals to A addition modulo 10 B addition modulo 10 C. This shows that addition modulo 10 is associative in R. We know that 0 belongs to R, and hence A plus 0 is equal to A for all A. That is, the first row having elements 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, which is headed by, which are headed by the zero element, that is zero. That is the row, the first row, namely 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 is exactly same as the topmost row. Therefore, 0 is the identity element. What about inverse? We know how to find the inverse. Here 0 is the identity element, and another thing is I highlighted in red color, so that is very easy to find the inverse. We know that inverse of 0 is 0, because inverse of identity element is itself inverse of 2. Now we have to consider the row headed by 2. The row headed by 2 have elements 2, 4, 6, 8, 0. Among these elements, 0 is the identity. The corresponding element in the topmost row is 2. Therefore, inverse of 2 is 8. Similarly, inverse of 4 is 6. Inverse of 6 is 4. Inverse of 8 is 2. Therefore, additive inverse of 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are 0, 2, 4. Sorry. Inverse of 2 is 8. Inverse of 4 is 6. Inverse of 6 is 4. Inverse of 8 is 2. Therefore, the additive inverses of 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 are 0, 8, 6, 4, 2 respectively. And remember that if you add the inverses, the sum is either 0 or 10. See here, 0 plus 0 is 0. 2 plus 8 is 10. 4 plus 6 is 10. 6 plus 4 is 10. 8 plus 2 is 10. Thus, we have shown that the quotient axiom is verified, associative axiom is verified, and it has zero element, that is identity element with respect to addition, and it also every element in the table has additive inverse. The next one is commutative law. Take AB from R. Therefore, A action model 10, B equal to the least non-negative remainder when A plus B is divided by 10. Also, we know that A and B are elements of R, and elements of R are integers, and the integers obey commutative law with respect to addition. Therefore, in the place of A plus B, we can write B plus A. That is equal to the least non-negative remainder when B plus A is divided by 10. And by the addition model, this can be written as B follow 10A. And remember that first you have to write B. Now it was maintained. Thus, addition model 10B equals to B addition model 10A. Thus, R comma addition model 10 is an abelian. Therefore, the ordered pair R comma addition model 10 is abelian group. What about the second one? R comma multiplication model 10 is a semi group. To prove that it is a semi group, we have to show that it is closed under addition multiplication model 10. The second one is associative law satisfied. To show that it is closed and the associative law satisfied, we need a table. Now we are going to form a table, the composition table for multiplication modulo 10. We have written the elements here. Here also elements of R. And just now I told you, whenever you fill the column, if the product is more than 10, divide the product by 10, write the remainder. If the product is less than 10, that is the multiplication of two numbers is less than 10, you simply write the product. You need not divide. If the product is 10 or multiples of 10, we have to write 0. This is how we have to fill any composition table. Now, the first row headed by 0. And we know that if you multiply any number with 0, the answer is 0. Therefore, we have 0, 0, 0, 0, 0. Now we are going to multiply by 2. We are going to fill the second row headed by number 2. 2 2 into 0 is 0. 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into 4 is 8. These are all less than 10. Therefore, we have written as it is. Whereas 2 into 6 is 12. 12 is more than 10. Therefore, divide 12 by 10. It goes once and the remainder is 2. Similarly, 8 twos are 16. When 16 is divided by 6, 6 is the remainder. Now the row headed by the number 4. 4 into 0, 0. 4 twos are 8. And these two numbers are less than 10. But now 4 into 4 is 16. When 16 is divided by 10, 6 is the remainder. 4, 6 are 24. So 4 is a remainder. 4, 8 are 32. 2 is a reminder. Now, 6 into 0, 0. 6, 2s are 12. 2 is a reminder. 6, 4s are 24. 4 is a reminder. 6, 6 are 36. 6 is a reminder. 6, 8s are 48. 8 is a reminder. 8, 0s are 0. 8, 2s are 16. 6, 8, 3s, 8, 4s are 32. 2, 8, 6 are 48. 8. 8 are 64. 4 is the reminder. 4 is the reminder. Thus, we have filled all the entries. Now, look at the elements in the entries. That is, these are the elements in the table. And all these elements are either 0, or 2, or 4, or 6, or 8. What are these elements 2, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8? They are all elements of R. And hence, all the elements in the table are elements of R. Therefore, R is closed. The next one is associative. Associative law with respect to Martesian model of 10. That A, B, C belong to R. Clearly, A, Martesian model of 10 into B into Martesian model of 10, C equal to A, Martesian model of 10, B, Martesian model of 10 into C. That can be easily verified, but you have to write in the exam. It is asked you have to write steps, all the steps in the examination. Therefore, Martesian model of 10 is associative in R. That's R, Martesian model of 10 is a semigroup. Now the third part is distributive laws. Let us check the distributive law. It is clear that the operation multiplication model of 10 is distributive over addition model of 10, which means if A, B, C are elements of R, then A multiplication model of 10, B addition model of 10, C equals to A multiplication model of 10, B plus addition model of 10, A Martesian model of 10 into C. Similarly, B Martesian model of 10, C Martesian model of 10, A equals to B multiplication model of 10, A addition model of 10, C Martesian model of 10 into A. Therefore, the algebraic structure R, Martesian model of 10, Martesian model of 10 is a ring. Now the important point is commutative law with respect to multiplication model of 10. It is clear that A multiplication model of 10 B equals to B multiplication model of 10 into A for all A comma B belong to R, similar to addition model of 10 we have proved already. This shows that multiplication model of 10 is commutative in R. Therefore, the algebraic structure R, addition model of 10, multiplication model of 10 is a commutative ring. Now the question is the existence of unit element. What is the unit element? As I have mentioned many times, the unit element or unity elements or multiplicative identity need not be always one. So far, we have discussed many examples. In all those examples, the unit element or unity element or multiplicative identity is one. But In this example, it is different. Therefore, this example is very interesting example and important example. Because this is the example which shows that the identity element with respect to multiplication or unit element or unity element is not equal to one. Because one is not here. In R, one is not there. R has only five elements, namely 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. Then what is the unit element here? We all know that how to find the unit elements or the identity element with respect to multiplication. For this, we have to look at each and every row headed by the elements of R. That is the row headed by 0 and headed by 2, headed by 4, headed by 6, headed by 8. Now, which row is exactly same as the topmost row, namely 2, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. That is a giraffe copy of the topmost row. First row is not the one. Second row, 0 is there, but 2 here, 4. No. Third row, 0, okay, 2. But here, 8 is there. It's not true. Fourth row, 0, 2, 4, 6, 8. Exactly. The fourth row, namely the row headed by 6, is exactly same as the topmost row. This is the topmost row. And the fourth row headed by number 6, both are exactly the same. Therefore, the corresponding element, namely 6, is a unit element. See here, the unit element need not be always 1. This is the example in which the unit element or unity element or the multiplicative identity is not equals to 1. It is 6. Thus, if A belongs to R, then A multiplication modulo 10 into 6 is equals to 6. Multiplication modulo 10 into A equals to A. For all A belongs to R. Or the row headed by 6. Every corresponding element of the topmost row, 6 is the unity element of the ring. Thus, this algebraic structure R, addition modulo 10, multiplication modulo 10 is a commutative ring with unity. Thus, we have proved the first part, that is the commutative ring is, the algebraic structure R, plus addition modulo 10, multiplication modulo 10 is a commutative ring with unity. The next question is it an integral domain? Let us check. For integral domain, we should not have any zero devices. A ring, a commutative ring with unity and having without zero devices. Now we have to show that this R does not have any zero devices. That is, product of two non-zero elements is not equal to 0. That is, product of any two non-zero elements is non-zero. That is a condition of without zero devices. Now, from the composition table, it is clear that the product of no two non-zero elements of R is 0. That is, if A is not equal to 0, B is not equal to 0, AB is not equal to 0. For example, 4, not equal to 0, 6, not equal to 0. The product is 4, not 6. See, you don't have a 0 here anyway, except these two. No other place has 0. No other place has 0. That means the product of two non-zero elements is non-zero. Therefore, we can say that R is an integral domain. So, this is an example of integral domain. Integral domain, we mean a commutative ring with unity and without zero devices. And hence, this capital R having elements 0, 2, 4, 6, 8 with respect to addition model of 10 and the multiplication model of 10 is your commutative ring with unity without having zero divisors. Therefore, it is an integral domain.